You know, it was only just a few weeks ago that Calgary had the honor and the pleasure to welcome our 1 millionth citizen. Just over 2 weeks ago, born at the Rocky View Hospital, as I'm told by the staff, he was an average size, just 9 pounds, 10 ounces. Baby boy by the name of Dashiell Waite. And he and his parents were very proud first parents, and it really speaks to the growing importance of Calgary and Alberta. It speaks to the need to reinvest back into our children and the need to invest back into public institutions, such as the one that we are in today. This truly is a world-class facility. It will, in fact, meet the needs and the challenges of not only Calgary, but southern Alberta, eastern Saskatchewan, western Saskatchewan, and eastern British Columbia, as it is a focal point and an entry point to some key children that need our help. Now, having spent the last hour in touring a very fine facility, it does, as you've heard from President Tour, it brings in more space and a lot of it. I was quite surprised and impressed as a parent with 4 children to walk through and see the very sympathetic design to deal with some very personal issues that we may face as parents. And as you walk through and you see those beautiful views of the Rocky Mountains and Nose Hill and others, you know, as a parent in sometimes very stressful situations, how much you respect the element of privacy of being able to speak one-on-one with your family physician. It has been a focal point of this board and a focal point of this community to ensure that we meet the needs of Calgary and Alberta's children. Those special touches are there and they have been done. But today is a direct result of many hands, many hearts, and many minds, all joining together to create truly a lasting legacy in this province. But it would not have been possible without the generous support of many, many people. And as we heard from our president just a moment ago, I want to personally extend to him. David Tour is a man that doesn't take no very often, very easily, and nor does he walk away from a very difficult task. So David, to you and your board, past and present, congratulations for a job very well done. It was a very tough assignment. We have many people here today, both public and private, government and not-for-profit, that have worked very hard. Students, and as you've heard, even little Katie this morning, Catherine, as her mother calls her, Katie, as she said I could call her, escort us to walk through about the importance of children. And you have seen, just by looking around, the importance and the direct result. But leadership is sometimes a very difficult task. And I, too, personally want to extend our support and thanks to our Premier, Premier Ralph Klein, that ensured that this project was not only funded, supported, and that the legislature delivered the money that was required to ensure that it got built today, on time, and on budget. Premier, thank you. As Mr. Tour outlined, there are many consulting contractors, and the list goes on, over 5,000 people that have worked very hard to recognize this dream here today. Our staff that have worked many, many hours, the foundation and others, this facility could not be constructed today without their support to recognize the value of our children. But in an hour or so just walking by, this facility has really become quite quickly about stories, and I want to share just one very briefly with you. You heard Mr. Tour talk about engaging children as the focal point, and as you walk down the corridor, you saw the various drawings of children who said, this is what the facility should look like. Very concerned by some that it may take on the effect of Legoland, they wanted to ensure that this facility was identifiable. Now, an anonymous caller one day came to my office and said, it shouldn't be that hard, Mr. Mayor, for the city to get involved in this project. You're very involved in the power of business, of course, and being the oldest utility in the province, you think you could maybe help us out? I said, sure, what do you need? Well, we just need to tie up a little bit of power, and it shouldn't really be that big of a task. I said, that's fine. I picked up the phone and called the chairman, Mr. McDonald of NMAX Corporation, and he, of course, picked up the phone and called the president and CEO, Mr. Holden, and they agreed it was a little bit of power, and I will now publicly acknowledge, I'm sorry, Gary, I didn't realize it was quite as far as They didn't tell me that when they gave the ask. A few extra kilometers of pipe and a few transformers, and we want to thank NMAX for their support. And then, of course, there was another caller to a fellow who actually resides in Vancouver, but very sympathetic, of course, to the cause of children and the promotion of health care in his own province of British Columbia, and a key supporter of this community and the various businesses that he's involved in. And that's, of course, none other than Jimmy Pattison. When I spoke with Jimmy, I said, Jimmy, it's really simple. I've just told that they're just looking for a sign. Of course, he did the usual grilling that he generally does with people that are asking him for something, and I didn't have a whole lot of detail. I said, well, Jimmy, it can't be all that big a deal. I mean, it was some kids that came up with a signage. You think you can help us out? He said, ah, sure, I'll help you out. I didn't realize that it was 24 letters, 12 feet high, lit up with neon, and comes with a seven-figure attachment. So, Jimmy, I'm sorry, but on behalf of the children, thank you. That was their design. We are coming. I share that story because, as David Tour mentioned, this was a hospital built upon dreams. And it was the dream of the children that are here to ensure that everything that they dreamt for could actually materialize. Everything from the piano to the dreams of ensuring that there were aquariums and others. And so if I could ask you to turn your attention to the monitor, you'll see how the dream of identification came from the children themselves.